This is a tandoori oven. We're going to use it during Indian cooking. It's usually used for northwestern Indian cooking for doing meat, fish on skewers, or bread, which typically would be naan, the type of bread baked in a tandoori oven. I just want to show you a little bit about the oven so that you're prepared for the first day of the evening menu. First of all, there's an on and off switch, and the temperature gradations go from 1 to 5. Typically, I will turn this on in the morning and gradually increase the temperature so that it is very hot, between 800 and 1,000 degrees by the time we're ready to cook. Then I will turn it down very, very low. You really don't want to put food into this oven after it's been preheated with the flame on high. The food will typically burn before it had a chance to cook all the way through. These ovens are lined with thick clay walls, about 4 inches thick, and they absorb the heat during the preheating stage. And that heat is held by the clay. You turn the heating element off, or almost off, for the cooking stage, and the radiant heat coming out from the clay walls gives an even steady heat that allows you to roast or bake bread at a very high temperature very quickly without the flame being present. Traditionally, these would have been fired with charcoal, and they would have been built into the floor or into the side of a hill that would have allowed for the insulation of the earth around it to maintain a constant temperature for a very long period of time. So once you've got it up to temperature, and they become very fuel efficient, you can maintain the temperature by only adding a little bit of fuel every so often because it's so well insulated. Now, the food that's cooked in here is generally going to be put on skewers. We have long steel skewers that we would put meat, poultry, or fish on. I found that these hooks are very useful for stopping things from sliding off the bottom. So what I usually do is take a raw potato if I'm doing meat or poultry, or a piece of a lemon if I'm doing fish, slide it on and put it down near the base so that it acts as a brake for the food itself. And even with that, the hook will keep food from sliding off the skewer into the base of the oven. Then you'll put your meat or fish or poultry on the skewer in layers. You don't want to pack it too densely together because what will happen is it doesn't cook evenly at that point. You can have, tomorrow we're going to do tandoori chicken, for instance. You can have the chicken pieces touching each other, but you shouldn't squish them together tightly because the chicken won't cook evenly. It'll be raw in the middle and burnt on the outside. There's an adjunct video that goes along with this one that demonstrates how tandoori chicken is made, so you can watch that for the chicken. But basically, the chicken will be put onto the skewer. The skewer would be placed hook side down in the oven. You can do multiple skewers at a time, so 4 or 5 skewers would not be unusual. And then the lid is put on. There's holes in the lid to vent smoke, but also to allow you to keep the skewer out. You have to gauge how much room you have on the end of your skewer so you don't overfill it. So rest the skewer in the bottom of the oven, grab it here, and see that really, this is only how much room you have to put chicken on. So if you put it up to here, it's not going to all fit in the oven. So make sure that you understand how much room you've got before you start putting chicken on the skewers. Now for baking naan, naan is a flatbread. In southern India, if they make naan, they usually use baking powder because it's a chemically activated leavener and it's more stable in very tropical heat. In northwestern India, where it might be a little cooler, you typically see this done with yeast. We do it with yeast for flavor and also just to learn how to use yeast a little bit better. Whoever is doing this tomorrow will have to begin the bread dough, the naan dough, very early in the morning. There's another video that discusses how to make the naan dough and how to shape it. But that should be the first thing that you do when you come in the morning, is to weigh out the dough, the yeast, the water, make the dough, allow it to do its rise. Once it's been risen and shaped, and again, there's a video that shows you how to do this, you will flatten it, you will stretch it over this, which is known in Hindi as a patty. You'll stretch it over the patty like a flatbread, think pita bread maybe, that kind of a shape. You grip the patty with your fingers over the neck. You place your thumb on the bread to hold it from sliding off because it's going to be held perpendicular to the floor. And then I advise you to take off your wristwatch and roll down your sleeves because it's going to be really hot in that oven. You can stick your arm with the bread in the oven and you're going to slap it several times against the side of the oven. And then close the lid, form another naan, another flatbread, and then slap that on the side of the oven as well. When it's time to remove the naan from the oven, we have two other tools. The naan will cook within about 3 to 4 minutes. You'll notice that it will start to bubble up and turn a light golden brown on the outfacing side. It's still stuck to the wall of the oven. It sticks pretty well to the clay. You have, for all practical purposes, we can call this a spatula. It's a long skewer that's flattened at one end, and we have a hook. You'll use these tools to get the naan out of the oven. You'll reach into the oven with the hook and spear it so that when you use the spatula to scrape it away from the wall of the oven, it doesn't fall into the flame. Then you'll end up with a piece of naan on the end of a skewer, on a hook. You'll take it across the table, put it on a cutting board, and brush it with a little bit of ghee or Indian clarified butter, sprinkle it with a little bit of salt, and cut it into pieces that you need. So, just to recap, you're going to need skewers for the chicken, you're going to need the spatula and hook for the naan, as well as the patty. If we don't have a patty, we'll make one out of wok rags. I will preheat the oven. Please work with me and don't put anything in the oven until you've spoken to me and make sure that it's the right temperature, that way you don't burn things. And lastly, be comfortable, or don't be uncomfortable. This is a very strange appliance to most Western people. It's something that you've probably never seen or worked with before. I expect that things will go wrong. And when they do, it's not going to be your fault. It's just going to be a lack of experience on your part. So we can have fun with it, we can play with it, and hopefully the food comes out well. If it doesn't, then it's just part of the learning process. So be a little bit relaxed. This is, if you're using a Western oven, you burn something, that's because you haven't learned it in previous classes. If you burn something in the tandoori oven, this is the first time. Give yourself a little bit of slack. Okay, thank you.